Wrestling fans, this is your TV main event. Introducing first, already in the ring, from Atlanta, Georgia, 250 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
And of course, this is our $10,000 bounty match. The winner is walking away with $10,000, and there's been a lot of speculation. And Orndorff is the man that's been putting out those posters, or having them put out, with Primetime Brian Lee's picture all over them.
You say Orndorff was the man who was doing it?
I say there's a lot of speculation that Orndorff may be the man that's doing that. And here is the man.
I'll tell you what, Paul Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful, you're out here running your mouth about 10 grand. Let's see if you can get $100 worth of prime time right now. Paula, 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 Paula.
And prime time, Brian Lee. I tell you, this guy is ready. He wants a piece of Mr. Wonderful, and he wants it bad.
Well, they're going right into it. Boy, this man's getting started too much. You see these two men going in. This is a bounty match for Paul Orndorff. See if he can pick up $10,000. Obviously, somebody dislikes Brian Lee that much that they can put $10,000 for anybody to knock him out of active competition. Competition in Smoky Mountain. Let me say one thing. What just happened here, the last segment, Dirty White Boy attacking Tim Horner, was one of the most vicious acts I've ever witnessed in all my years of professional wrestling. But now Bob Armstrong to come out here and say that Tim Horner can have all the title matches he wants, that depends right now on Tim Horner and his condition.
Well, his condition.
And we will try to get an update on his condition before this match is over.
Yeah, Dutch, we don't know what it is. And as you say, that was you had never seen anything like that. Dutch, I've been around a long time, and I've been around the horn a lot. I've seen a lot of wrestling matches. I've never seen anything like that. I've never seen anybody stoop so low as to do something like that with a noose around the neck to literally hang somebody from the rope.
He was bleeding from his mouth, and his eyes were rolled back in his head. A vicious act by Dirty White Boy. But yet, at the same time, you got to be a man in this sport. You got to stand up, and you got to watch yourself for attacks like that. Tim Horner talking big, saying he wants this, he wants that. Well, I think he underestimated the viciousness of the Dirty White Boy.
And I don't think there's any doubt about that.
And he found out firsthand.
Well, I tell you, you're looking at a man in the ring in Primetime Brian Lee, where fans all over the Smoky Mountain area are riding in support of this young man, Brian Lee. He's literally battling for his career against a variety of opponents, some he knows and some he don't know at all because of the warped individual that's writing all those letters to Bob Armstrong. Dutch, who could have such a grudge against wrestling, or a grudge against society like that, that he would put a price on a man's head, that he would send anonymous threatening letters to the commissioner, that he would hire a band of misfits to cause chaos? Dutch, who in the world would do something like that?
Dan Quayle?
Oh, no, Dutch. What? No, Dutch.
You don't think Dan Quayle could do it? Maybe Bill Clinton could do it. Who knows?
Hey,
I know a lot of things, but I don't know that. I will say I don't know who is behind this. But I know Brian Lee, he had better watch his every step. He better be looking in the back seat of his car. He better be looking at every room that he goes into. He better watch every motel or hotel he stays at. Because obviously somebody is watching him, and stalkers can be very dangerous because most of the time they're anonymous. You don't know who they are.
That's right. And evidently there's another stalker. Dutch, we believe now that the first stalker that we've seen is named the Mongolian Mauler. And the contract that was sent to Bob Armstrong has been signed, and Brian will be meeting this huge man very soon.
Well, Brian Lee, first of all, before he can meet anybody, he's got to get through Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Let me tell you the strategy that's going on right now with Mr. Wonderful. He is not going to try to attempt just to pin Brian Lee. That's the farthest thing from his mind, because what's most important to him right now is the $10,000 that's on Brian Lee's head. A pin would do him no good. Actually, he might want to pin him just for self-satisfaction, but he would still like the $10,000 just to say, just to claim, just to have that claim to fame that he put Brian Lee out of active competition in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Well, prime time, Brian Lee, he's really been carrying the match to Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. He had Orndorff outside of the ring. He worked him over outside back in. He's gone to the arm now. And with an arm bar, he had a lot of leverage and a lot of pressure on that arm and on that shoulder as he continues to attack Orndorff. Orndorff now trying to come back. There's some good forearms, and he's got a lot of power in that right forearm blow. Goes down from a block as he comes off of the ropes, and he comes off hard. Right back to the attack very quickly. It's prime time. Brian Lee right on top again.
Good wrestling move by Orndorff.
It was a great one. He dove for the head, and Brian Lee saw it coming, pulled right out just in the nick of time, Dutch.
Now, you see, let me tell you what's going through Brian Lee's head. He's going to have to try to keep this this attack up. A good defense your best defense is a good offense. And what he's going to try to do is maintain control of Mr. Wonderful and never let him get the upper hand, never let him get the momentum to swinging in his direction, because if he knows that, I think, and everybody knows what a dangerous man, what a dangerous creature Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff is, and Brian Lee fully realizes that, even in that feeble, inactive brain that he possesses.
Here's a smart guy. Prime time Brian Lee, a smart athlete, a smart wrestler in the ring, Dutch.
Well, he's not too smart because he went bungee jumping the other day.
Always goes
and
in.
And he did
the ring
it wrong.
A good game plan, no
he
doubt
didn't
about
jump
it.
Off. He didn't tie the cord around his feet.
How did he do it?
Tied around his neck.
No way.
Brain damage.
Dutch, we've had tremendous matches.
Big elbow drop missed by Orndorff.
And if the dream matches that the fans send in are any better than these, it's certainly going to be a November to remember.
Well, what if people write in and say, I'd like to see Dutch Mantell take
That's
on Bob
right.
Collar. Would you climb in there with
yes,
me?
Yes, sir, Reed Dutch. We'll get in there.
You're a tough man, aren't you?
Yeah, but I may not last but about a second or two, but we'd do it.
All right.
Hey, also, fans, keep in mind that the deadline for the entries is October 7th, and also there's going to be a grand prize awarded to some lucky individual.
Yeah, the grand prize mostly, is dinner with me.
It's been mostly primetime Brian Lee in this match. Dutch, I think he has really taken the action too, Mr. Wonderful.
Well, that's what he's going to have to do to see if he can... See, the best thing Brian Lee can do right now is just hope to get out of there intact and without an injury.
Through the ropes he goes. Orndorff, he was waiting on him when he came charging off of the ropes.
Smart.
And there goes Lee right... through the ropes, off of the apron, down under the floor.
Smart move for Orndorff because he had Brian Lee's 285-pound momentum already going. All he did was slip in there and just give him an extra little boost, shooting right outside the ring.
Yeah, and with that much weight and all that power behind it, no way Brian Lee could stop.
He brings him right over. It takes tremendous strength.
Man.
Tremendous strength. See, that rope is at least 4 or 4.5 feet high, and he has to lift him over that. The body cannot drag. If the body drags, the move is flawed.
So yeah, Dutch, you're right.
A lot of strength to suplex a man from outside in.
Nobody's ever going to say anything about the power and the strength of Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. He's got it all. He's a complete package. There's no doubt. He's got the athletic ability. He's got the size, the power, and the strength. Also, the wrestling knowledge and the experience. He's got everything in his corner, Dutch.
Yeah, let me tell you what else that $10,000 bounty has put on Brian Lee, other than added pressure. He has made a lot of wrestlers wake up and see the potential in wrestling Brian Lee. Not only Paul Orndorff, not only Dirty White Boy, not only the Heavenly Bodies or Robert Fuller or Jimmy Golden. There are other wrestlers across the country, and I know they know what's going on here, and pretty soon a lot of men already shooting at Brian Lee, and that number is going to quadruple in probably the next couple of weeks, as soon as word gets out on the grapevine.
Well, Brian Lee had a lot going for him. It had been his match up to this point when he was clotheslined.
Orndorff off the top rope.
Oh, right into the knees. Prime time. Brian Lee got the knees up right into the midsection of Paul Orndorff. Out near the center of the ring now. Look at those big right hands. Roundhouse right hands by Brian Lee.
Big power slam.
Drove the shoulder hard right into the midsection of that power slam. And this could be it, Dutch.
Now,
it could be over right here.
Brian Lee on the top rope. What's he going to do now?
He missed it that time.
Now, that move right there was brilliantly stupid. Brilliantly stupid on Brian Lee's part. Now, why did he get up there on the top rope?
And well, it was awfully slow taking place.
Well, he telegraphed that he may have well sent a telegram.
Wait a minute. Orndorff's out of the ring. Where's he going?
You see,
he's got the bell.
See, he doesn't
He's got
care.
The ring bell.
He's got Brian Lee now. Now, see, the bounty
oh,
theory.
Oh, no, wait a minute. He shouldn't have that in the ring. No way. He's going to pile drive
well,
him.
Well, you
he's
see
gonna
the
try to pile drive him on the bell.
Referee calling for the bell, I think. Wait a minute. He's got him up in the pile drive. He can't do it.
Brian Lee. Brian Lee
almost bought the farm on that one.
The referee says stop. It's all over.
The referee
has stopped. Right.
He has stopped the match because he brought the bell in the ring and trying to get him. Now Brian Lee's got it.
Ooh. And Orndorff, he ducked out from under that just in the nick of time. Orndorff went out. He got that bell. He took it into the ring. He was going to pile drive.
Prime
time Brian Lee.
Well,
referee Mark Curtis has disqualified Paul Orndorff, your winner of the match, Primetime Brian Lee.
Well, let me say one thing right now. Primetime Brian Lee, he dodged the bullet on this one, but there will be others, and they may be more successful.
And fans, we'll be back. We'll have more right after this.